Hey guys, welcome back to JQ's World Retro Saturday. Alrighty guys, how's everyone doing today? So today I have very exciting news. I'm not going to be doing any gameplays right now. I have done the gameplay and that video is being uploaded right now. I played Metal Slug 2, a full gameplay of Metal Slug 2. You can see me raging or getting mad that I died or whatnot. But anywho, the great news right now, as you can see, Pandora Box. This Pandora Box of the arcade is sponsoring my YouTube channel now. And I'm so thrilled and very honored to be given this chance and opportunity to promote them. So I'm going to try to do my best to give them a full good tutorial about this arcade machine that Jose gave me. Alrighty. So, as you can see, the introduction obviously is Pandora Box HD with all these classic retro gamings. Now, I don't know if you see my unboxing. Please go back to the videos. You see me unboxing the whole entire arcade machine. But like I said, this is how it's done. You guys can insert a few quarters right here. There's a start button, there's a quarter selection, and then you have your classic A, B, C, D buttons. Now, once you put in the quarter, as you can see, you hear the sound, you inserted one quarter. Then you can move around with the stick, choose any classic games. They're not all alphabetized, but at least they're, you know, categorized like all fighting games and then, you know, puzzle games and etc. and etc. So as you can see, you have all the Kingdom Fighters from 97, 98, 99, 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, and so on. All different type of Kingdom Fighter. I'll go down to the list of all the games that they have here. You can take a look at yourself, what you're expecting once if you decide to get one of these things. But for me, it's really worth to get one of these things. They're really, really good. Right now, I'm happy to have this because my YouTube channel has gone much more better with retro gaming because people are going back to the retro gaming. Not too many people are, you know, having too much fun with the new generation's games like PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and I'm a big Xbox One fan, but I'm not really having too much fun. I like going back to the old classic days where you didn't need to buy too much fucking DLC things. As I was saying, like I said, like there's a lot of different classic of Kingdom Fighters. I myself am not a huge Kingdom Fighter fan. I'm mostly into the shooting. I do like fighting games, but mostly like Marvel vs. Capcom or Street Fighter. Kingdom Fighter is an interesting game. I'm not going to say it's not, but I'm just not good at it. I really suck. So as you can see, they have all the classic Metal Slug 1, 2. They have different versions of Metal Slugs, as you've seen. Metal Slug 3, 4, 5, and number 6. Like I said, now since we finished with those fighting categories of... Oh, never mind. We're back again with Kingdom Fighter. 2003. Oh. My apologies. I forgot to let you know. My apologies. I forgot to let you know. This thing has a timer. So if you do not pick a game, the thing will choose for you. It's a little annoying, but if you want to, you know, get rid of that, there is an option to do that. I'm going to go. This is a tutorial, so I'll show you exactly what you guys have to do if you want to get rid of that. But I haven't changed that setting because, you know, I'm weird. So, in case if you want to continue, you know, exploring, just insert another coin and you see the timer goes back to 99 minutes. Still going down the list, we have, you know, SNK. And here comes the classic, Marvel Super Heroes. Marvel vs. Street Fighter, one of the awesome games that I love playing. Me and my best friend, Lanteria, always play this game. This is when I first started my YouTube channel. I started with this game, but I didn't have this machine. I had another arcade machine, but unfortunately, it didn't have the capacity for the Elgato, you know, to connect it or whatever. So I always had to use my 4K camera to point at the arcade machine and then record my shit there. It didn't look good quality wise compared to what I'm doing now with this. We continue going down the list. Marvel vs. Capcom. X-Men. Definitely a classic. X-Men versus Street Fighter. Where it all started, the crossover. Then you have all the Alpha 1, Alpha 2, Alpha 3. This is the Q game, Pocket Fighter. I think you guys know about this. It's a hard game for me, I'm just saying, but it is a fucking fun-ass game. Then you have a lot of wrestling games. You have a few Darkstalkers games around here. And then they have different type of alphas. WWF, they actually have Jackie Chan game. I never even knew Jackie Chan had a fucking game. But it looks kind of fun. Kind of corny and cheesy, but fun at the same time. Then here we go with this. Some other, you know, fighting games. Beat-em-up games. Who doesn't like a beat-em-up game? Classic Punisher, Final Fight. The good thing about the arcade, the one that I have is, how you call it, is a one deal package, because it comes with basically it's built in together. Two cabinets for you and your friend can play together in this arcade game. I think there's a way to put a third player. I haven't tried it yet, but I know that there is a way to do it, but it's going to take me a while to figure out, the same way how I figured out how to connect this to my Elgato. It took me a long time to do it. Going on, they have the classic Simpsons, Golden Axe, Pac-Man, if you guys are a big fan of Pac-Man, definitely Strider. I actually like Strider 2. Strider 1 is fucking hard. It's like literally fucking dead ass hard. I can't beat this one. I can beat part 2. But the very first Strider is fucking hard. I see other people do it like if it's not. But for me, uh-uh. I won't last 5 seconds in that game. Alien vs. Predator. Mega Man 2. Sailor Moon. For me, I never knew Sailor Moon had a fucking game. Me and Anterior actually played this by ourselves. We haven't recorded it, but hopefully me and Anterior, or my good friend Mono, who's a big fan of Sailor Moon, might want to come down and actually play this with me. Oh, RoboCop. This one looks like a good game as well. Like I said, these are all classic game. Rambo 3. Moonwalker. Always a classic. Don't you guys just miss the old days when you guys used to just put in a quarter, just have fun? Nowadays, in the future, you have to buy shit. Like, seriously, why do you need to buy $5 worth a skin, or fucking, how you call it? Oh, shit. I keep on forgetting about this. Lady, go! Alright, there we go. I'm back to the thing. Let me just put a free quarter so they won't bother me. Alright, still going down to the list. Oh, and if you guys want to know the total of games, how much is in here, it is 680 games in here. Still going down. X-Men, yes. Now, this is what we all grew up with. Oh my god, I love this game. I fucking love this game. The good thing, I'm happy that they made an arcade edition of this game. Besides the Sega Genesis, because once you die in the Sega Genesis, you gotta start back from the fucking beginning. Unless you know, not the Chico, but there's like a saving pattern in the Sega Genesis. Still going down. You got Double Dragons. It's always a classic. Oh, man. Ninja Baseball Batman. Oh, my God. This brings back so much fucking memories. It's kind of like Scott Pilgrim, but with people with bats and beating the shit out of people. They're not even fucking people. I don't even know what they are, but it's fun to beat the crap out of them, though. All right, moving on. Oh, we have the classic Batman. I'm Batman. Oh, Mario, here we go. Now, this is what we're talking about. That is way old school right there. Have no idea what it is, but it looks like fun, though. still going down. There's a lot to go down in this list. Really a lot of games. Now we have these Metal Slugs, but these are like the extended edition of Metal Slug. That's another thing. I know these are kind of like the as a previous game, but they have like additional things, like hidden weapons or missions that they wasn't in the previous game. Like I said, they're the Japanese version of the previous game, and it's actually more fun than the original. I have no idea what it is, but it looks like fun though. Let me put a coin before my time runs out. Then you have your classic Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2, Aliens. Which one is this alien? Oh, okay, yeah, that one. I remember that one. Yes, we keep on going. Whew, I'm going to be here for a while going down all the games. There you go. You got Street Fighter 3. Then you got Street Fighter 2. Then you got the other new generations. I know this is some Japanese bullcrap, but looks okay. I mean, I'm not mostly into anime, but I know people who are into this type of things. Never heard of that game. Oh, here we go. Street Fighter. Now, this is the funniest thing right now. Watch this. As you guys know, these are all the classic Street Fighter from Street Fighter 2. The regular Street Fighter, they have Hyper Edition, they have Turbo, they have the X version, they even have the broken version of the game. Which one was it? Was it this one or was it this one? Let me see. I forgot which version it is, but there's one Street Fighter game that I was playing and it's like completely broken. Like one fireball can equal 10 fireballs. That's how bad it is. I actually sat down and played with it, and my god, I got murdered in a fucking instant. You think you could cheat this game, but no, they fucking cheat on you. Like, literally, they have no mercy. Oh, this is the one. There you go. This is the version. You do a Shoryugus, and fucking 10 fireball comes out of fucking nowhere. Watch it. See that? That's half your fucking health right there, man. Man. See, look at that. Look at that. Oh my god. Then they have the classic Street Fighter. Then they have Mega Man. Samurai Showdown. I remember those. Sorry about that. I'm just trying to organize myself while I go through all these games. There is really a lot. Now, most of you people are asking, is this worth investing to get this? From my point of view, yeah. There's a lot of good choices here. You can always sit around with a friend, a pal, and, you know, kill the time playing these classic games. Because, like I said before, I mean, I don't mind the new generation of game, but it's just getting boring and dull. So I go back to the old classic where it used to be, you know, so good. And I don't know. It's just good to have a buddy side by side playing games, killing shit, shooting airplanes. God, these things are fucking amazing. Ah, boy. Keep on forgetting about fucking doing that. Lady, go! Sorry, buddy. I'm still in tutorial mode. Can't play yet. Oh my god. I love this one. I love this game. I grew up with this game. It's hard to beat this game. I'm not going to lie. It's fucking hard to beat this game. And part 2 is even fucking worse. Part 2. I used to have this type of game on part 1 and part 2 for PlayStation. And they only give you a certain amount of credit. You have to do with exactly 9 credits. You die with those 9 credits, you start from the fucking beginning. This is why with the arcade, you can play as much as you want. Oh, and before you guys go crazy about this, no, these ain't real coins you guys are putting in. These are fictional coins, as you could call it. There's basically, there's a button right at the arcade that says coin. You just put in a coin. You can put as many coins as you want. I could just go crazy on it. And not give two damns about it. Especially since I'm gonna be doing my YouTube channel. I usually do everything. I do retro, I do this generation's video games and whatnot, but like I said, I want to just go back to the old school where everything used to be simple back then and they don't shove microtransactions up your fucking throat. I mean, what else can you want? And this fucking game has everything. If you guys are into soccer, hey, this is a good chance you might find something you like here. Basketball. They have everything. I know these people must sit down every fucking day, take requests, demands of what games they want inside their arcade machines and whatnot, what they want to play, what they want to do. I believe they do take requests, if I'm correct. I'm not going to be 100% sure, but I think they take requests of what type of game do they want and whatever. I'm almost to the end of the list right now. Hold on. Just give me a minute, then after that we'll play one game and I will end the tutorial from there. Let me just go a little bit faster. Almost done, almost done. They got Galaga. Wow, Galaga. I mean, those machines, Galaga, still fucking exist, believe it or not. Alrighty, I'm up to the last 10. I put a quarter for they won't fuck me over. And we are done. 680 games we went through. Like I said, they're all here. You could play as long as you want. Put fictional coins inside the fucking game and play whatever you want. So right now, like I said, I'm going to give you a tutorial. I finished up with the tutorial with a gameplay. For example, have you seen how many times I got cut off because it selected a game by itself because you have a timer right there? So, for example, if I play this game, right, and then I regret playing this game because I suck, all I have to do is just press the coin button, the start button, I'm back to the menu. Simple as that. Once you guys, you know, insert a coin and select what game you want to do, all you got to do is either press the start button or the A button and you're off to go. Now, the good thing about this arcade thing, so example, pretend you want to turn off the volume of the TV. This thing has its own volume. Like, I'll give you for an example. I don't even need the TV volume. All I need is the arcade volume, and it's loud as hell. Really fucking loud. I'll give you a quick look of a quick test run of how loud it is. Here you go. You heard that background? That's the arcade. That's not. All right, so I'll just pick a game. It's very fucking loud. Now I'm gonna lower the volume on that shit. There you go. Now you can hear me and the normal game setting itself. Now, like I said, if I wanna play this, I could just press start. But if I don't wanna play it, all I gotta do is just press coin, start, Oh, sorry, I'm supposed to press them together. There you go. I'm back to the main menu. Now, there is settings to, example, if you get rage like I do and you want to, like, take it easy, there's a green button in the back. So on this green button setting, you get to set your settings, like how many coins you want, the difficulty of each games. I call it everything here. All you gotta do is just press the A button. So, example, I'll go to game setting right here. Press the A button. Which, see, right here you have A is for difficulties and lives. B is for, I call it editing games lists or whatnot. You can edit your own game list. Like, if you just want to focus on whatever game you prefer to play, you know, you just make a list and you just go through your list. You don't have to go through all that. You just pick whatever your top 10 favorite or 20 favorite games you would like to play immediately without going through all that hassle. I haven't made my list yet because, like I said, I recently got this. So if I don't want to do any editing, I just want to leave the difficulty as it is, I'm just going to press the letter D and I'm already done, so I press A. Oh, sorry. Press D and D. Hold on, how do I get out of here now? I think I just pressed the back button, the back green button again. Let's see. Or maybe coin and start. Oh, right. To get out, you just save whatever settings you put on the arcade, but since I didn't do anything, I'm just saving and going back to the beginning. Alright, give me just 1 second. Alright, you have to go through all this again. The introduction is fucking amazing. I fucking love this music. It just motivates you to go fucking play a video game.
The Phoenix! Woo! Chapter Box 4. Special.
Super special. Enjoys life with quality. That's for sure. Alright, so again, like I said, I insert a coin, and now I will choose a game. So, since I am giving you, I'll just give you one small gameplay of anything right now. So, let me go with, let's go with Marvel's Capcom. Because who doesn't love Marvel's Capcom?
Lady, go!
Let's go crazy!
That's right.
Marvel versus Capcom!
Let's go.
Ready. Fight.
You fucker. Yeah, don't mess with me, son. I'm hype. You dick Strider. Time to turn to evil Kuma. Well, not evil Kuma, but you know what I mean. Evil Ryu. Alright, time to finish it with a double special.
You
see the high quality in this game? It's fucking amazing. You can fucking see their dimples. Ba-da-ba.
We Let's are go, Bob.
Ready. Fight!
Where's the Mirage?
Venom Fang!
Damn! Get him! You prick! Alright, Ryu, tag him! Damn! I'm gonna show you with you! Adios, Mega Man! Hadouken! Damn, I actually thought I was gonna do something. Oh yeah.
You win.
I'm gonna disrespect you, Venom! Alright, as you see, I'm having a lot of fun with this game right now, so I'm gonna call quits right now. There you go. I tag right back out, and let me just play one more game before I end this tutorial. Let me see, what else game am I good at? I don't even know what game am I good at. Like I said, it's been a while since I played an arcade machine. But let's see, let me pick a classic. What could I find? What can I get? I actually want to do a full tutorial. Actually, let me play X-Men since I already done. If you go back on my previous channel, I did a full gameplay of X-Men. So if you guys want to take a look at that, please let me know. Me and Terry had a great time playing that game. Me and Anterior had a great time playing this game.
Lady, go!
Press start. Choose your X-Men. As always, I'm a Cyclops, so let's go.
In the 21st century, evil mutants led by Magneto aim to destroy the world. Humans can do nothing against the power of the evil mutant. The only hope is the X-Men. Go and save the city!
X-Men! Oh shit. Arctic blast. Out of my face. Ow. Shit, I don't have any more for my arctic blast anymore. Take that. Stay your ass down, boy. Yeah. Bitch. Ow. Oh. Don't die yet. Why die? Well, that's about wrap it up. Hopefully you enjoyed this full tutorial. Hopefully you guys might consider getting one of these lovely machines. Well, thank you for watching this. Please comment and subscribe to JQ's World for more gameplays. Take care. Have a good night.